Children with the autism spectrum conditions often have trouble recognizing the emotional states of people around them. For example, distinguishing a happy face from a fearful face. To remedy this, some therapists use a kid-friendly robot to demonstrate those emotions and to engage the children in imitating the emotions and responding to them in appropriate ways. This type of therapy works best, however, if the robot can smoothly interpret the child's own behavior, whether he or she is interested and excited or paying attention during the therapy. Researchers at the MIT Media Lab have now developed a type of personalized machine learning that helps robots estimate the engagement and interest of each child during these interactions using data that are unique to that child. Armed with this personalized deep learning network, the robot's perception of the children's responses agreed with the assessments by human experts with a correlation score of 60%. It can be challenging for human observers to reach high levels of agreement about a child's engagement and behavior. Their correlation scores are usually between 50 and 55%. The MIT researchers suggest that robots that are trained on human observations, as in this study, could someday provide more consistent estimates of these behaviors. Their long-term goal is not to create robots that will replace human therapists, but to augment them with the key information that the therapists can use to personalize the therapy content and also make more engaging and naturalistic interactions between the robots and the children with autism. Personalization is especially important in autism therapy. The challenge of creating machine learning and AI that works in autism is particularly vexing because the usual AI methods require a lot of data that are similar for each category that is learned. In autism, where heterogeneity reigns, the normal AI approaches fail. Robot-assisted therapy for autism often works something like this. A human therapist shows a child photos or flashcards of different faces meant to represent different emotions to teach them how to recognize expressions of fear, sadness, or joy. The therapist then programs the robot to show these same emotions to the child and observes the child as he or she engages with the robot. The child's behavior provides valuable feedback that the robot and the therapist need to go forward with the lesson. The researchers used SoftBank Robotics Navo humanoid robots in this study. Almost 2 feet tall and resembling an armored superhero or a droid, Navo conveys different emotions by changing the color of its eyes, the motion of its limbs, and the tone of its voice. The 35 children with autism who participated in this study, 17 from Japan and 18 from Serbia, ranged in age from 3 to 13. They reacted in various ways to the robots during their 35-minute sessions, from looking bored and sleepy in some cases to jumping around the room with excitement, clapping their hands and laughing or touching the robot. Most of the children in the study reacted to the robot not just as toy but related to Navo respectfully as if it was a real person, especially during storytelling where the therapist asked how Navo would feel if the children took the robot for an ice cream treat. Therapists say that engaging the child for even a few seconds can be a big challenge for them, and robots attract the attention of the child. Humans change their expressions in many different ways, but the robots always do it in the same way, and this is less frustrating for the child because the child learns in a very structured way how the expressions will be shown. The MIT research team realized that a kind of machine learning called deep learning would be useful for the therapy robots to have to perceive the children's behavior more naturally. A deep learning system uses hierarchical multiple layers of data processing to improve its tasks, with each successive layer amounting to a slightly more abstract representation of the original raw data. Although the concept of deep learning has been around since the 1980s, it is only recently that there has been enough computing power to implement this kind of artificial intelligence. Deep learning has been used in automatic speech and object recognition programs, making it well suited for a problem such as making sense of the multiple features of the face, body, and voice that go into understanding a more abstract concept such as child's engagement. Deep learning allows the robot to directly extract the most important information from that data without the need for humans to manually craft those features. For the therapy robots, the researchers took the idea of deep learning one step further and built a personalized framework that could learn from data collected on each individual child. The researchers captured video of each child's facial expressions, head and body movements, poses and gestures, audio recordings and data on heart rate, body temperature and skin sweat response from a monitor on the child's wrist. The robot's personalized deep learning networks were built from layers of these video, audio and physiological data, information about the child's autism diagnosis and abilities, their culture and their gender. The researchers then compared their estimates of the children's behavior with the estimates from 5 human experts who coded the children's video and audio recordings on a continuous scale to determine how pleased or upset, how interested and how engaged the child seemed during the session. Trained on these personalized data coded by the humans and tested on data not used in training or tuning the models, the networks significantly improved the robot's automatic estimation of the child's behavior for most of the children in the study.